Welcome everyone, thanks for checking out my YouTube channel at GoneBadDog123. Today we're doing a return flight back to Los Angeles, and we're in a 737-700. Here at Las Vegas it's a little bit windy today, so we're going to have a little bit of a crosswind taking off. We got winds 250 at 10, gusting to 19. So I've got my plane set up, so go ahead and get our altimeter set to where I'm going to be going to. And I'll get down here at the runway we're going to be taking off. Could take off on across the regular runway, but it's too short, so we gotta play with a little bit of crosswind today on takeoff. Alright, so get ready to go here. There's 236, we should be able to go southbound here, so. Make sure all my doors are closed. Nope. Got my side doors open down there. My baggage handler forgot to close my doors. Alright, everything's locked up, secure. Got one other program to check. It's recording. I'm also using a program called K-Cars. I'm in with a flight group at teamspeak3.msflights.net. Everybody's welcome to come over and check our server out. Very good bunch of guys, and hope to see you there. All But anyway, we're here at Reno. We're heading back down to Los Angeles. I don't know how to cut and edit, so this here is only going to show the takeoff and the landing. Be a little bit shorter. I just uploaded one from LAX to Reno, so this is going to be the return trip. Should be under our recording enough to get me up to altitude and from altitude back down to landing. I know some people like to see the whole video, but some people don't. So I don't know how to cut and edit, so I'm just going to record the front end and the back end. Alright, we're going to stop here and make sure we got everything going to do the altitude and the heading, and we get lined up here. I'll get my heading set up. I should have looked at the little box over there on the ground to see what runway this heading is, but I'm playing in the movie Langoliers. Nobody here but me. We're going to say 165, 164. Give or take a little bit either way. All right, we're going to click this. We'll do that on. We click this. Yeah, it won't. N1 won't do anything because we don't have it set. So we'll have to find our N1 box. Alright, here's our N1. And you set it for 80 or 90%. And she'll pull that 85 to 90%. So now you hit N1, just be sure to set it to your airspeed once you get up off the ground, because if not, she'll keep accelerating. And we'll probably have a wind will be coming. Steeper here so we can get above this range down here. flaps up. Pull up my little map here. Get past this little range here, then we can get back on course. Taxi light off here. Turn it off. And we can go ahead and turn our landing lights off. We're right at 10,000 feet, so click on a VOR now. We're safely above the mountains here, so we can follow our course. And we don't need our map up here now. You can check our map here by looking at our cursor here, and we'll see the bucket plane back into the right a little. Yeah, for my scenery, I'm running a global base and vector, and for weather, I'm using Active Sky Next. And if we run into rain or anything, I've got a program from FX that does precipitation. So that program's $15, and they also have the A320 immersion for aerosols, A318, 19, 20, and 21 series aircraft that you can see wing vapors, jet blast. You see a blast from your reverse engines, brake smoke, intake vapor. So the plane's what's cost the most. The program's only $25. I bought the A318 and the A319 for I think 32 pounds or 38 pounds. Or Franks, or whatever it is for Germany, where Aerosoft's located at. So, it's a little bit of a learning curve, flying those two planes, but FMC, there's a gentleman that I learned from his, and I need to leave a comment on his webpage that his teaching helped me learn to program the FMC for the airsoft. Now, if you're in the Bowens, it's the same type of setup, but it's I haven't tried it. I don't have no British planes store-bought. It's all freeware. Those are the only two planes I have that I bought that I'm flying on p3d right now. So we get getting on up at altitude here, and I'll wait till I get to altitude, and a couple minutes into that I'll sit there, pause the game or pause the recording, and see you at the landing. It's only like probably about, all total is about 50 something minutes recording time. 50, it's under 1 hour. So hope y'all enjoy it, and please subscribe, and we thank you for tuning in for the takeoff, and see you there at the landing. Okay, folks, we're a little bit too close here, so we're going to have to swing out and do a long kind of oversnacked myself there, so that's not no problem. So we're gonna be running runway 7 right anyway, so we're gonna swing out over the ocean. Just gonna get rid of the check our map here. If I can find my runway for 17 or 7 right. I got my California map here. We can always come in runway 7 left, 111.10. Seven left. Go to our chart here. Now we're going to go to our radio and put 111.10 in nav 1. Let's get this pulled up here a little bit. We hit nav 1 and 111.10. And hit the switch here. It'll jump over to here. So we got our set up here. Go ahead and get our radio out of the way. And we're not going to activate our approach yet. corner. Do a scenery refresh because that's supposed to be water out there. Alright, we're going to go ahead and drop our throttle here. We don't need it now. Beeping you here, stating that we're getting close to the ILS. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to have to do a scenery flush here because this is supposed to be water, not land. And we'll be coming in on runway 7 left. I want to do a scenery flush here. We can go ahead and turn off that beeping here. Yeah, we don't need it, so we're already on glide slope here. And we get rid of our map here and our radio. See, this is supposed to be all water here. Here's the beach up there. We don't need this approach now, so we're going to go ahead and turn it off. Turn off our autopilot. Commerce Port. Coming in with a tailwind. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to LAX. Time is 2:47 in the afternoon. Please remain seated till the plane is parked at the designated parking spot. And we hope you enjoyed the flight. box here, and we're pulling this spot, parking spot, to the left here. And there we have it. Let's get ready to shut the plane down here. Make sure all of our lights are off. All the lights are off. And we go down here to the console here. And you'll see. Move our throttles up out of the way here so we can see our button here. Engine 1 shut down, or I should say number 2. Parking brake is on. Open the doors, hit Control J, okay folks, that concludes our little flight coming into KLAX, and I hope you enjoy the flight. If you liked the video, please subscribe, and we'll see you on the next video. This is Flight Nut at Gone Bad Dog 123, and we thank you for watching.